Can one person be both the Scrum Master and the Product Owner? After all, the Product Owner is just requirements engineer, and the Scrum Master is just the team personal assistant, right? And by having the same individual accountable as the Product Owner and the Scrum Master, we can save lots of salary budget, right? Folks, if you're also interested to know the reason why we should have two different individuals as the Product Owner and the Scrum Master, stick around because we will elaborate it right after this one. So as many of us already know, in Scrum, there are three accountabilities: the Product Owner, the Scrum Master, and the Developer. And when Scrum said that these are accountabilities, it means these are not job titles. It's not even roles. I've made videos that explain these three accountabilities. Go check out those three videos on this channel if you haven't watched it already. So here's the thing. Scrum Guide does not explicitly say that the Product Owner and the Scrum Master must be two different individuals. However, in the Scrum Master section in Scrum Guide, there is a paragraph that explains the Scrum Master's service to the Product Owner. So when you think about it, if the Product Owner and the Scrum Master are the same individual, the company will have a self-serving individual, someone who is not interested in other people's interests. Of course, we don't want a self-serving individual in our company, right? The developers may have an interest in bringing in technical excellence into the product development process. They may also want to pay technical debts in the product. But a self-serving individual may ignore the developer's interest and ask the developers just to complete more product backlog items. And as you have already watched on my other videos, this will just lead to a feature factory. Turning Scrum into a feature factory is one of the reasons why developers hate Scrum so much. The developers may also have an interest to work at a sustainable pace every sprint. Now, a self-serving individual may ignore all of that and treat the sprint as a mini waterfall instead. Quite often, mini waterfall will lead to burnout or overburden. Overburden in the software development industry is quite common, and Scrum wants to avoid seeing developers being overburdened. Because when the developers are overburdened, they won't enjoy developing the product, and that usually leads to low-quality products. Scrum has always been about quality first, and that's why the definition of done needs to be made transparent to everyone in the company so everyone understands the level of quality the Scrum team strives for. Besides avoiding a self-serving individual in the company, by having two different individuals as the Product Owner and the Scrum Master, these two individuals will be more focused so they can be great at their respective areas. As someone who is accountable for maximizing the value of the Product Owner needs to have access to the budget for developing the product. We can't expect someone to be accountable with the return on investment of the product if we don't allow them to manage the budget. To maximize the return on investment of the Product Owner needs to be entrepreneurial. Being entrepreneurial requires vision. The Product Owner therefore needs to have long-term vision for the product. Besides vision, being entrepreneurial requires looking outwards at the problem that the customer is facing. Being entrepreneurial requires the Product Owner to understand the current market trends and the competition landscape. In some industries, the Product Owner needs to be aware of the current global issues and the latest government regulation. Now, as you can see, the Product Owner is an outward-looking individual. They must be in tune and find opportunities outside of the company that can maximize the value of the product. Now, if the Product Owner is a more outward-looking individual, the Scrum Master focuses on looking inside the company and finding opportunities to improve the Scrum team's effectiveness in delivering valuable and releasable products. The Scrum Master needs to view the whole company systemically, because sometimes the factors that contribute to the Scrum team ineffectiveness may come from those outside of the Scrum team. Sometimes it is the company's internal politics and bureaucracies that is impeding the Scrum team to deliver valuable and releasable products. The Scrum Master should not be limited only to working inside the Scrum team though. Limiting the Scrum Master only to the Scrum team will only lead to suboptimal performance. the Scrum Master should be empowered to make a change in the company so they're able to improve the Scrum Team's effectiveness to an optimal level. Check out my video on how to measure the Scrum Team's effectiveness by clicking the card up here if you haven't already watched that video. Because the focus of the Product Owner and the Scrum Master is different, the skill sets required to be an awesome Product Owner and an awesome Scrum Master are also different. As an entrepreneur in the company, the Product Owner needs to be effective in managing the budget for developing the product. That means they need to be financially savvy and needs to know accounting. Besides financial metrics, they need to know how to interpret the correlation of evidence-based management or EBM metrics. They need to have the knowledge to make a future projection based on these metrics. The product owner must also have knowledge to craft small experiments that will validate assumptions from the stakeholders and also their own. The product owner also needs to have negotiation and bargaining skills so they know how to handle conflicting needs from the stakeholders. The product owner should never be the proxy between the stakeholders and the developers. The product owner also needs to be good in making sales pitches to get buy-ins from the customers, the stakeholders, and also the developers. And of course, the product owner needs to have skills in product management. On this channel, we have already quite a lot of videos on Scrum Master. From the 8 Scrum Master Hats video that I have already made, we can break down the skills that the Scrum Master needs to have. The Scrum Master needs to have effective teaching, coaching, and facilitation skills. That is for sure. The Scrum Master may have technical skills that they can use for mentoring others in the company too. They need to know several agile practices that they can use for mentoring and teaching the developers and also others outside of the Scrum team. They need to know how to use the evidence-based management metrics to improve the Scrum team's effectiveness. On top of that, the Scrum Master needs to know lean thinking and systems thinking too. As written on Scrum Guide, the Scrum Master is required to advise the company on how to roll out Scrum throughout the company. Therefore, they need to understand organizational design and the psychology of change. As such, the rollout throughout the company does not cause resistance and confusion. And of course, the Scrum Master needs to master Scrum beyond just what's written on the Scrum Guide. Now, many of us already know that the Scrum Master is a true leader who serves. I often describe the Scrum Master as a leader who leads from behind. Well, the product owner is also a leader. They lead from the front. They lead people towards the long-term vision of the product. That's why the product owner needs to be an inspiring leader. As leaders, both the product owner and the Scrum Master are people-centric and great communicators. Together with synergy, they're able to engage everyone in the company with the process to develop the product and towards the vision of the product. As we already know, focus is one of the Scrum values. When the product owner and the Scrum Master are two different individuals, there will be more focus. The Scrum Master focuses on making systemic changes in the company that will lead to delivery effectiveness, so the product owner does not need to get drowned in internal company politics and can focus on maximizing the value of the product. When we have a self-serving individual in the company, either the value of the product does not reach its real potential or change in the company is slower than it should be. But when the product owner and the Scrum Master are two different individuals, there will be checks and balances. With those checks and balances, the product owner and the Scrum Master will sharpen each other so they can be more awesome at what they do. Those checks and balances should also result in a higher quality and valuable product. That is all from me today, folks. Thank you for watching today's video until the end. Hopefully today's video helps you see the value of having two different individuals as the product owner and the Scrum Master at your company. And hopefully from today's video, you will come up with a list of action items to leverage your product owner and your Scrum Master to be more awesome than they already are, rather than putting unnecessary layers above them. And if you like today's video, folks, don't forget to click that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel because we're almost close to 10,000 subscribers. I will see you in the next video, folks. Now deliver something amazing to your customers. Bye now.